and once more, you're most welcome to Crazy4Veggie.com. Now today I'm going to make a rotlo that is also called Bajre ki roti, or you know, millet flour roti. Now this particular, you know, rotlo will go perfectly with a spicy curry, like, you know, moong curry with buttermilk. Definitely you can find this recipe on my site. Another is stuffed baingan and like stuffed eggplant and potato curry, that also you can find. And the most important combination is baingan ka bhartha with this rotlo, and this is my most favorite combination. You know, whenever I make baingan ka bhartha, definitely I will have this rotlo. Now you know what, this is not, I cannot say it a little bit harder, but you need to get, you know, some time to keep your hands on this rotlo. It will take few try maybe, and then after you are, if you didn't make it before, definitely it will take few try, but definitely it's not so hard. So okay, then stay tuned with me and, you know, follow some tips which I'm going to give in between my rotlo recipe. So let's start our rotlo. Okay, so now let's start to make rotla. Now for this rotla we need a bajri flour, a millet flour that is called, and it is easily available in any Indian grocery store if you are living in, you know, like some big cities. So yeah, and this is the Jalpur brand. I have, you know, used so many brands of this flour, but this, as far as all that brand, this brand is perfectly like, you know, that bajri flour. Otherwise, you know, in some brands I have, like, I feel that, you know, that it don't have like pure flour. Some flours are, you know, just mixed with it. So yeah, if you are lucky enough to find this brand, then definitely use this one. Now I'm going to add this to my water. Now here I have taken 1 cup of water, and into that I'm going to add salt. We have to add as per our taste. Okay, so mix it with your hands and you know, taste it. If you feel less, you can add more, because I'm going to make a chew rotla out of it. So judge your salt level as per how many rotla you are making. And it's better to, you know, like make a dough for like one rotla at a time, or maximum two rotla at a time. And then again, after you want to make more rotla, then, you know, again knead the dough. That will be the better way of making. Okay, so now I already mixed this. So now we have to add a flour into it. So I'm taking flour into my measuring cup, and I'm going to sift it. One more cup I'm going to add, and I will see how much more I want to add. So 2 cups at this point. I'm going to use 1/2 cup only right now. Oops. Okay, now let me remove my rings. And you should have to clean your hands thoroughly, because we have to make a dough with our hands. So I need more flour. Okay, now we have to knead this dough very well. Now see, the more you are going to knead your dough, your rotla will be, you know, more soft yet crispy. So you must have to knead your dough. Okay, so now at this point, see, I'm going to see that it will come out with 2 medium rotla. So that's fine, you know, I don't want to add some like more flour. So it's almost 2 cups of flour, you can see. So you can use 1 cup of flour for 1 rotla. So now I'm again, you know, kneading it. Okay, now see, like I didn't need to add more water. I use only 1 cup, little bit less than 1 cup. But you know, some flour soaks more water, some flour soaks less. So definitely now at this point you must have to judge, and you like, you cannot, you know, just follow the measurement what I'm going to give. because that's depend upon your flour. Now one more tip, that you know, this millet flour, generally in India we grind it fresh and we use it within a 10 to 15 days, otherwise it will become bitter. So in here in Indian store also that happened, you know, like 2-3 times flour were so bitter that I couldn't use it. So it's better to, you know, that you keep it in a like refrigerator. After you open it, even if you when you buy it, you just keep it in a refrigerator, so it will have a long life. Okay, so now it's enough. So now we have to roll our rotla. Okay, now before I'm going to roll my rotla, this is my clay pan, and you can see that it will be like that. Now I brought this from India, and I didn't see here, means you can find it in Indian grocery store, but it will be costly. So, and you know, this rotlas will taste so perfect with if you are making this in a clay tray. But if you don't have, you can even use the regular pan, but I cannot have my rotla without this one. So now I on my stove, and we have to let it hot, because when we are going to drop our rotla here, it should be really hot. So I already started my stove, and now again let's work on our rotla. Okay, so I'm going to take right now one rotla dough like that. Now roll it between your, you know, two palm. Now I make this like small ball out of it. So you know, we just have to roll it first between our palm, and now you know, at this point I'm going to make a rotla. Now we have to, you know, use our both palms, and we have to give pressure to it like that, and we have to move it. Now see, traditionally in India and even in like my house, you know, my mother, my sister-in-law, my mother-in-law used to make this rotla with only hands. That is the traditional way of making rotla, but I cannot make it like that. So what I did here, I just, you know, put some flour here, the same millet flour, and now I'm going to place this here, and now gently I'm going to roll rotla. See, now you don't have to give a pressure. If you are going to give a pressure, then you know, this flour is so soft, other and it will stick to, you know, bottom. So that's why gently we have to give pressure, and you know, you have to roll it like that. You have to give pressure here on your fingers, okay, like that. Yeah, now you don't have to give pressure on your palm. So you can see that easily it's getting round and it's moving. Okay. Now this middle part is thick because I didn't press here. So now at this point, just press like that. Okay. It's so easy. It just need practice. That's it. There is nothing hard in this rotla. If you have good practice, then you are ready to go with the same kind of rotla you can have. Okay. So now I roll my rotla. It is that much thick. You can see. I think, yeah, it is thick. It's not thick, not thin. Rotla is like this, the perfect size. So now I'm going to, you know, put this into my clay tray. Okay, so now I'm going to drop my rotla here, but first of all I want to remove this all the dust, because if you have a clay pan, then you know, whenever you are making something, it will sometime, you know, just stick here and it will burn. So that's why I wanted to clean it. Okay. So now it's clean. So at this point, and it's hot also, pretty hot. Okay. So now at this point, I can drop my rotla over here. Now here is the trick of dropping rotla. So I'm showing you that. Okay. So now how you can take this rotla in your hand is, you know, place your fingers and your palm like that, and move your partly, and now take in your both hand and gently place it. That's it. Now see, you must have to be very careful while placing it on a pan, because if you will leave air inside, it will create air bubbles and then your rotlo will not come out good. So you must have to place it gently and you have to take care that all the air will pass away and there will be no air. If there will be air, then you know it will create some bubbles over here, but as you can see that there is no bubbles, it means this is the perfect way. I just drop it. Now take few water drop and just spread here. Okay. Because I have used flour to roll it on this side, so I don't want to I don't want my rotla to be dry on this side, and sometimes it's like looking like breaking little bit, that I don't want. So that's why I always use little bit water here. Now I keep my flame on a high, little bit lower than a high, and we have to cook one side 25%, another side, this side 70%. So now at this point it must be done because we don't have to cook more. So take a spatula and move gently, and if you are not able to move, if it is sticking, then wait, because it's cooking. So don't force to just stick your spatula inside it. As you can see, I can easily enter my spatula, so that's why now it's perfect time. Take in your hand and that much is perfect. Okay, now another hand, place it like that, and now on that side we have to cook 75%, but wait for 1 or 2 minutes, and then after you will be able to move your spatula into rotlo. So then after you can just shift and cook as per you need. Okay, so now it's been like 1 minute, so now I'm going to move my rotlo, but I cannot easily enter my spatula here. Rotlo is still stick to bottom, so that's why I will not force on my hands. I will wait another 1 minute, so after that it will automatically come out. Okay, now it's been more seconds, few seconds, around 30 seconds to 1 minute. Okay, at this point I can move my spatula, but from the between here it's still sticking, but you can see the smoke is coming out of here, so it means that it can be burned. So what I'm doing is to hold my pan and I'm gently pressing it, we don't have to break it. I'm gently pressing it and I'm trying to move it. Oh wow, see, it's come out, but see, you can see that over here it's burned, so definitely we don't want it. So now you can see that here is uncooked. So what I'm going to put it here, and that way it can get direct heat, and the other side which is already cooked little bit and like burned, we don't want to give heat to it, because it can burn more. So that's why. And now at this point I'm going to lower my flame bit, because this is so high flame, this stove has a so high flame, so that's why I need to keep it low. But if you don't have so much high flame, then you don't need to slow it down, and we have to move it and we have to check that it's properly cooking. Okay, you can press if you want, so it can cook here also where we see that it's uncooked. Okay, now again I'm going to take it, and now at this point our rotlo is cooked from this side, so we have to drop it on another side. Now at this point it will going to create air between these two layers and our rotlo will be puffed up. So now at this point higher flame, okay, and wait for around like 1 minute, and after a few seconds press your spatula here. So after like you expect, whenever you're pressing this, it will give help to create more air between your two layers. So, and even if it's creating air in between, you can see, because your rotlo will be puffing up, and you can see even in its shape. So now at this point, I'm going to press it like that. We don't have to press so much that, you know, it can break. So press it like that. Okay, so now I'm using my hands, but if you are not good at it, don't use it. See, you can see here, it's opening now, and this is the fluffy, and it's puffed up with air. So at this point, our rotla is ready. So I'm going to take this in my plate. And you can see there's some stuff, you know, which is burn on another side, it stick here. So when you are going to put another rotla, just clean it first and then after put it here. Okay, so now I'm going to cut it. Press your knife in one part and, you know, separate this both part. Okay, and keep remaining some part stick together, and you can see that this is a very thin layer of our rotla and this is a thick one. Okay, and now I'm going to apply ghee, because without ghee, you know, rotla is incomplete, and definitely you cannot substitute it with butter. That's another thing, if you don't like a taste of ghee, you can use butter, but this is so yummy and delicious, and I'm going to use lots of ghee. Okay, press your spoon so ghee, rotla will soak the ghee. Okay, and that's it, your rotla is ready. I'm going to have this rotla with odo, that is called bangan bhartha in my own language, and this rotla will taste so perfectly like bangan bhartha and rotla. This both are, you know, you can call it mad for each other. Hey guys, so yeah, that's it for my recipe of how to make a rotla. I really wish that you enjoy my this recipe. Now for this recipe and many more, please visit my site at www.crazy4veggie.com for printable recipe and detailed ingredients. Stay tuned with me and I will definitely come back with my another recipe. Till then, take care. Goodbye.